picks and bans for the third game of the spring split. First ban out the gates, Copenhagen Wolves have taken Lee Sin off the table from Ulix. That's not a massive surprise. It is his most played champion by a long, long way.
Yeah, and again, Lee Sin has been banned in every single game we played so far. Rek'Sai on the red side, not really a surprise with her. And Leona being banned away here against Unlimited, I actually quite like it, because if you look at Copenhagen Wolves in the summer split, they lost a lot of the games when Unlimited was playing passive disengaged support, because they have no way of starting team fights. Whenever he picked up Leona, he actually performed really well, and I actually quite like the ban.
Well, we'll see how it works out for them. LeBlanc and Zed to round out the Copenhagen Wolves bans. One left for HTK to take off the table. That is, of course, both of the coaches on screen. Dentist for the Copenhagen Wolves, and of course, Proly for H2K. The final ban is Kalista.
Wow.
Taking that away from Freeze. We know Freeze to be a Draven player. We know him to be an aggressive player. And I just want to highlight, this is the third game in a row. Gnar is unbanned. It hasn't been picked in games one or two. We'll see if it goes through. You've also got the likes of Lissandra, Rumble, all of those top tiers still available.
Yeah, but I mean, look at the last game. We had Renekton against the Jax when Lissandra was open, Gnar was open. That's very different from what we have seen in other regions. And for Copenhagen Wolves, I mean, Lee Sin being banned away, you get Jarvan, second best jungler here, seeing as Rek'Sai is always going to be banned, that's fine. Kassadin and Janna being locked in for H2K, not really showing too much. Kassadin is a flex pick, can go mid lane, can go for this top lane here. So just a decent of lock-in. Not the biggest fan of blind picking the Kassadin in this situation here, but they really want to have it for most likely Odoan playing this top lane.
Well, trust Proly being the coach to have an influence in that one. We'll have to see how it pans out. Now, there's been some talks about Cassiopeia has been locked in along with the Gnar. So, gonna expect to see Youngbuck wielding the Shapeshifter.
Yeah, Youngbuck on Gnar in the top lane, Cassio in the mid lane for Zoran. It's been a pick a lot of the EU mid lane and top laners have actually talked about. She has a very, very strong 1-5 laning phase where she can dominate pretty much everyone. Get the stacks rolling again. You want to get to 100 stacks and 250 and 500 by applying poison to minions, champions, whatever, in order for her to really scale up to late game. So very, very strong laning phase, but you can gank her fairly easily. She's immobile, and therefore you can try and shut her down. And this is actually the problem with early picking that Kassadin for H2K, because Copenhagen Wolves respond with Gnar, Cassio, two champions who will have a good time against him in the laning phase.
Well, we'll see how the laning phase works out for Copenhagen Wolves. We know that as a team, they tended to run very, very long games during the summer split last year, and they've got an incredibly strong early to mid game aggressive team comp. It is rounded out, Draven and Annie. We touched on it. Freeze is one of the loudest Draven players there is.
Oh, for sure. And Copenhagen Wolves just going full on for the laning phase here. You have Cassio, Draven as well in there together with the Annie pick. They engage for Unlimited, even though Leona was banned away. And of course, Gnar, who is an extremely strong laner himself. So a lot of focus on the early laning phase here for the Copenhagen Wolves, getting that lead going into the mid game and try and do what Giants and Fnatic has already done today.
Well, we'll see if they've got the coordination to do it. H2K lock in Sion. That must be a top lane Sion for mid lane cast, and we'll wait for the cookies to crumble and the roles to all swap around. Deficio, what are you anticipating from this Sion versus Gnar matchup? It has been seen periodically over the last few weeks, but definitely not super common, not in the top tier.
No, and Sion, he doesn't have the best laning phase. It's all about farming for him, just build full tank, and then you have to try and make plays with your ulti. And I love watching Sion ulti, because either he smacks right into the first wall he sees, or he lands it on three people and it just looks amazing. So we're gonna have to see what Odoamne can do on this Sion pick here. Will be a free lane for Youngbuck though on Gnar.
Now I'm gonna go a little bit, I'm gonna put myself out there. If there is a top laner that could pull it off, Odoamne could be the guy. This is one of the more impressive top laners that we've seen from the Challenger or the LCS level. And he's gone for a new champion here on the first day of the spring split. It's gonna be interesting to see how it pans out.
It is a risky pickup. I mean, there's not a lot of damage on H2K's side. Kassadin in the mid lane needs time to scale up. And then you have Graves as the AD carry. Sion will be full tank and won't really kill anyone by himself.
Well, we'll find out how Odoamne builds it. The team comps are on your screen at the moment. Vote on who you think has the better team comp. Who do you think is gonna win this game? At LOL Esports, use that hashtag CWWin or use the hashtag H2KWin. We will check on the results as your votes come in. Do you believe in the undead power of Sion or not? We're about to jump into the first matchup here between Copenhagen Wolves and H2K. It is a grudge match for H2K. They need to prove that they are better than their 0-3 defeat at the hands of Copenhagen Wolves last year, and they need to do it after losing Febivent and replacing him with Ryu.
And the Copenhagen Wolves needs to show us here their solo laners can actually carry games, because on Cassio and Gnar, you're not just sitting back and supporting your AD carry. You're part of the whole damage-dealing trio of your combo. So Soren and Youngbog needs to really step it up this year if Copenhagen Wolves wants to move up the ranks and not end once again as one of the bottom teams, because every single season Copenhagen Wolves has played, they've been down in the bottom, been to relegation.
Well, we'll see how that pans out. We'll touch on that in a second. As Unlimited, with the help of Soren, is putting some poke onto H2K. H2K seem to have control of the jungle thus far. Let me get some deep vision down. And, you know, the point you were touching on, Copenhagen Wolves have struggled during the regular LCS, but they always seem to step up during playoffs. You know, summer splits, they had a 2 KDA as a team. In the playoffs, they had a 7.4 KDA. Somehow, when Copenhagen Wolves' backs are against their walls and their jobs are on the line, then they figure out how to step up their play. But it is also against challenger squads.
I feel like they prepare really well if they have enough time to do it. And that's a problem for them in the LCS, where every single week you play these two games. So you don't really have enough time to just sit down, find out exactly what to play, multiple weeks of scrimming, find out what works or not. And that's what sometimes bites Copenhagen Wolves a certain place. And one of the reasons they haven't really been able to perform. So Freezy and Unlimited want to start the Crooks, and Voidal just moving in, wise enough, denying it.
And of course, he's on that Janna. We didn't mention it when we saw Janna previously, but slightly narrower missile whiff on that Howling Gale. This mid lane, Ryu's going to have a little bit of a difficult time against Cassio, who is quite aggressive and quite a lane bully.
Yeah, so the thing about Cassio right now, because he can start Flask and full potions and just focus on farming, he's pretty hard to actually bully out of the laning phase. He should be able to pick up quite a lot of farm. But Soren will have all the pressure in his lane. So if Nawix joins in and they take a 2v2 fight against the likes of Ryu and Lulix, then it's going to go heavily in favor of Copenhagen Wolves. Just look at the poke already. Land the poison, your E has no cooldown then, and you just spam away.
Well, let's see how much CS Ryu is forced to lose by the pressure that Soren puts down. We do flick up to top lane very briefly. It is Gnar versus Sion. So the first Gnar of the summer split, spring split rather, 2015 season, and the first Sion that we're seeing here in Europe. He's already put a couple of points, it's double check skill order. So one into his E, Roar of the Slayer, one into his W, Soul Furnace. We'll keep an eye on how he skills it up.
Typically, you're maxing your E in the laning phase and you use it to like poke from range, because you don't really want to all in, like he's doing right here. Good timing, get the minion, get some damage on Youngbog as well, and then you just focus on sitting back, getting as strong as possible. Use your teleport there to create picks on the bottom side of the map instead.
All right, we'll see how well Odawame can do in this laning phase. H2K cannot afford to give up early advantages. We touched on the picks and bans, how Copenhagen Wolves comp has got bullies all the way down the line. And if they manage to garner a lead from those bullies, that's how they can start to get some control and strangle H2K out of the match.
And what H2K decided to do in the pick and ban phase, once they saw Draven being logged in, they actually said we don't want to lane swap against it, because we don't want to let Freeze just sit back and stack up on this Draven here and have a nice time early on in the laning phase. So we want to make sure we have a top lane that can actually stand somewhat toe-to-toe with the Gnar, so we can have this Graves and general lane take the 2v2 and deny Freeze at least a little bit of CS. For now though, he's been doing a very good job for him.
We'll see how we can keep that up. When you think about it, Freeze is really one of the few Draven players left in Europe. He's not a champion we see very often. And we need to keep an eye on how well he can cash in on those stacks. Copenhagen Wolves and HTK still going at it. Youngbug gets locked up in the air. Little Wamne, no aggressive summoner spell, but again, he's bullying Youngbug.
Yeah, and Youngbug is not really respecting the damage coming from Odawamne and his E here. He just managed to walk around the creep. Youngbug doesn't really react to it, and then he just lands or fires a minion into the face of Youngbug, and there's quite a lot of damage with it. Have to respect the Sion a little bit.
Well, we'll see how the lane continues to pan out. Sion just a touch behind in CS. Youngbug not really looking like he was putting a lot of pressure onto Odawamne, but Odawamne also with the Flask Potion start. So much like Ryu in the mid lane, going for the sustain, going for the extended laning phase. Look, here comes Lulex on that Elise. The cocoon needs to land. Let's see if it can. Repels to a minion. That's a flash away from Young Bucks. Slow it down. The red buff is ticking. Young Bucks locked in place. First blood goes to Sion. He swings the smash and gets the kill.
And again, you land the CC onto Gnar here. Lulex with the very first gank off the game. Meanwhile, look at Airwax here. He's just been walking in the jungle of H2K around the blue buff. Plays the pink ward, which is typically a bush you don't actually check when you walk by it here. So hopefully for top lane Wolves, he's going to stay there for a while and just try and counter jungle a little bit. Meanwhile, Lulex with the early plays.
Well, we'll see how Odawamne builds himself. Does have makings of a tank to begin with. Glacial Shroud picked up. Mana and CDR, he's going to be punting those minions all around the map. Let's see if he can keep bullying Youngbuck. But I think you've got to give some props to Lulex punishing Youngbuck for overextending. And something else we haven't touched on, the changes to Smite in 5.1. Some good damage from Lulex down on Kerwax. I'm going to give him some presence in the mid lane. H2K, not a bad start considering how much pressure they have to deal with against Copenhagen Wolves champions.
Look at Lulex here, straight down to the bottom lane. He was spotted, however, around the Raptor camp. And Copenhagen Wolves backs away from it. But yeah, the smite changes. It now stacks up to 2 smites, of course. A bit longer cooldown, 75 seconds. And there's a 15-second cooldown as well once you have to use your first smite here. It simply means for late game, you don't have to worry too much about saving it for that potential dragon or baron. You can actually use it in the fight, have it ready again for when the objective starts it. Wow, Youngbuck's
going in, got that level 6. Nah, stun zone, Odawamne against the wall. Youngbuck may consider a tower dive. He's got a lot of hit points to work with. No flash Lulex available to him. Here comes Lulex, spiders coming in. The kick doesn't look like it connects, so Youngbuck is not slowed. Here comes the unstoppable onslaught. He doesn't manage to really get a massive hit, but it doesn't matter. Lulex gets the stun. Odawamne there, Lulex punishing Youngbuck.
And H2K just punishing Copenhagen Wolves for putting their focus on the bottom side with Lulex once again. He's staying around the mid lane. He again plays some deep wards, but he doesn't have any pressure on the top side. And Lulex, 0 wards from Youngbuck, walks straight up, kills him twice now, keeping him down.
Well, Odawamne definitely knows the limits of his champion. Gets in, does manage to get that brief connection with the unstoppable onslaught, and he now finds himself 2-0-0. Gonna get very, very tanky. And it's gonna be a problem for Copenhagen Wolves to deal with. Keep in mind though, Gnar does have that percentage HP damage, so he should be able to bully him if given the time. But obviously all of those tanky items is gonna make it very, very difficult.
Yeah, and meanwhile in the mid lane, Ryu, even though he didn't get any help from his jungler, has actually been doing really well in farm. And that's the thing about Kassadin. When you have the flash, you have the magic shield, and of course all the potions early on, you just sit back and farm. Normally a Jarvan would be able to go in and actually pressure you. But once again, Airwax, he's been doing nothing in this game and just allowing H2K to control the map.
You know, when you look at Soren from the summer split last year, he never really stood out amongst the EG mid laners. He had pretty average stats if you look across the board. Decent kill participation, decent GPM. The only problem is his best moments really came when it was in team fights. You seldom saw him, you know, dominate a lane. You seldom saw him take control. And it's once again coming true. And look at the itemization. Gonna go for, again, a later item build. So gonna give Ryu even more sort of time in that lane. Knowing, of course, Cassio can build AP from a passive, but nevertheless, it gives Ryu some breathing room. You can't deny that.
No, for sure, but TA is still a very, very nice option on Cassio early on, especially against the Cassio because you don't get pressured. So yeah, you won't be able to really
pressure yourself,
You kind of trade the late game power on both Cassio and Kassadin in this case by stacking this tier early on, get it into an Archangel, which you will need because you do actually scale really well into late game. As long as you can land an ulti and as long as you can land your poison in the late game team fight, you have a lot of damage on this Cassio.
Well, luckily for Soren's Cassio, he's going to have a Cataclysm, an Anti-Tibbers, a Youngbuck throwing down Gnar's Mega Gnar ultimate. That's going to work out as well. So you're going to have a lot of options available for massive amounts of CC. Take a look at this. There's going to be a party in the middle lane. Jungler's coming in. Soren has been jumped on. Airwax toying with the fight. Can they flag and drag land? The flag, the drag. Lulex gets dunked. First fight, and that's Ryu. Caught up as well. Soren manages to get the kill.
Oh,
but he gets caught down. Odawamne, they miss it.
Teleport as
he
well.
Goes wide. This is a teleport from Youngbuck. That looks like it was cancelled. And Odawamne comes running from downtown. just to stretch his legs.
But this is what we talked about earlier with the 2v2 skirmish in mid lane between a Cassio and a Jarvan against the Kassadin and Elise. It is in favor of the Copenhagen Wolves. They have more burst damage. We saw them turn around, 2 kills for them. Suddenly back in the game, we have Freeze Unlimited. Well, Sylphron joined the party as well.
A lot of damage between Freeze and Unlimited getting put down onto H2K's bottom lane. But Frozen Heart completed for Odawamnek. He's got that run all the way from top. Wasn't impactful this time around, but props to Ryu. He jumped in there, got the kill into Soren, so at the very least, it ended up being a fairly even trade. Tippers is down. Voidal gets caught by the Whirling Death. Freeze is getting all the damage down into Hyannon. Monsoon's going to keep them alive for the time being, and Freeze, thinking about the dive, decides against it. Copenhagen Wolves stamping their authority. That was a flash.
Yeah.
Hoppa! You don't have an unlimited use of that spell, my friend. And nobody saw it. Nobody saw it. Come on, come on. Nobody saw it. Misclick, misclick, guys.
Bit of a misclick here. Airwax, let's see what he wants to do. He could actually go for a dive on his bottom lane, even though there's no flash for Unlimited, because Voidal has no ulti himself. He's walking in.
Well, let's see what he wants to do. There's no Cataclysm, so let's keep that in mind. Low mana on Hyannon. Flash and heal available for Hyannon.
You want to try to give the kill over to Freeze at the moment. You can catch it. Soren moving down as well. They're going for it.
Let's take a look how this works out. Hyannon has been caught up. He's stunned. Who gets the kill credit? Tower is still tanking Unlimited in the background. Freeze catches in plus 590 gold, if my eyes see correctly. And that was fairly well executed by Copenhagen Wolves.
Yeah, nice setup. Lulix, or Eric, sorry, went in and actually just stood there. He didn't do anything, waiting for Freeze to finish it. Instead though, or at the same time, Copenhagen Wolves goes straight for Dragon.
So, early game power of Wolves is showing through just a little bit now. Odawamnek is winning the top lane, but he's got pretty good trades and exchanges for the rest of the Wolves down the bottom half of the map. Dragon, it took a while, but does get secured. And if you actually look at the gold, Freeze has 2,500 gold to spend. He's probably going to go back and finish that eye edge at 12 minutes on the clock. Let's look at the items and see what has he completed, and it is a 12-minute Infinity Edge. That is very scary if he gets those picks.
Very scary stuff. In this team fight, it's all about Odawamnek staying around Freeze. He's building in Frozen Heart early. Works really well against the Gnar, of course, and against the Draven. It's going to be all about Odawamnek trying shutting down Freeze in team fights.
Odawamnek around a bit. Tower.
He's in trouble.
Putting some damage in Odawamnek. Here comes Luka. Oh. Cocoon connects. Youngbuck gets caught out. He's going to go down. Odawamnek gets his third kill of the game, as well as a tower.
Like these junglers, one of them is sitting on the bottom side. He gets the dragon. He gets a kill for his AD carry as well. The other one, he's just sitting top lane, constantly feeding Odawamnek on this side here. He's going to be so tanked.
Well, H2K have got 1,400 gold in the advantage. They've got a tower in the advantage.
Why did Jumbo go back, though? I mean, your tower is already gone.
I don't know.
You only have one ward, and you know the enemy jungle has been around you pretty much the entire game long. Just give up that tower. You don't risk anything.
Oh, look at this. H2K are putting even more damage down. Inner turret, absolutely nobody's around. They do decide to back away finally as Airwax and Soren move in the back lane. And Airwax is a player on Copenhagen Wolves that we haven't really spoken about too much. He's been fairly decent thus far in the game. He hasn't necessarily counter-ganked for Youngbuck, but has secured a kill and 2 assists. Mid lane ganks were good. Bottom lane gank dive was good. And the dragon.
A bit of a rough start where Lulix definitely had the edge, got the early ganks on the top side, and Airwax didn't really make anything happen, but we've seen him come in and commit to some ganks, but once again, the teams have just traded wards. Freeze and Unlimited will be spotted down here.
Well, should run on top of that ward, so.
So that ward is, okay, actually smart enough, cleared up by Copenhagen Wolves. It's a super smart ward to place when you have a top laner who can actually teleport down and gank if Freeze and Unlimited were pushing up the wave. So smart enough to check it and actually play it here, because teleport would be ready for Odawamnek very soon.
Well, let's see what he decides to do with it. Blue buff donating over to Ryu. He's got that Rod of Ages completed. First major item, Soren got Giant's Belt with a tier, so going to be working towards that Rylai's, as is fairly standard, I think, on Cassio's. Unlimited and Freeze, really, really like that bush. They're looking for a gank. No flash tibbers for Unlimited because of the minor misclick earlier in the game. But Freeze, of course, with a small item advantage. IH completed versus the pickaxe BF sword.
They've been waiting in this bush for at least a minute now. And obviously H2K decides to back away. Haven't seen the duel in anywhere else on the map, so you have to expect they are standing around you. And plays it very safe. Odawamnek, though, some action in this mid lane. They might be able to push it down because Zorn has gone back to do the Merc Wolves. No dragon is up just yet, so just a roam down for this mid tower.
Gonna get some damage down on this one. Copenhagen Wolves, they're really in position to commit to a fight. Gonna try wave clear, but Thorn's wave clearing is fairly short range, so tower secured.
It's fairly slow as well.
Opportunistic move from HDK, and Oduwamne with another successful decision, another successful move. Good play.
So as you just said here, Kashio, her wave clear relies on her being able to twin fang all the targets and kill them with poison on, so she just burn them down instantly. If members are standing on those minions, she can't do it. She's too close to them, so she has to back away, and therefore her wave clear is a bit slow when it comes to defending a tower here. And HDK, full advantage now.
Oh, that's a flash turbus. Voidal gets caught out. He flashes away. Ignite is burning down. Here comes Oduwamne, the unstoppable onslaught. Is it going to get charged? Is he going to connect? He does. Airwax gets caught. He flags. He drags. He's away. He's alive. Here comes Youngbuck. There is no Mega Knight available. He needs to charge. And Tibbers gets booted away. Sion wants none of that teddy bear nonsense. Ryu takes a little bit of damage and all the action results. Nothing at the moment. A hop away for Youngbuck and H2K have got the entire team looking at the tower. Yarnen is hitting the tower. Copenhagen Wolves, five members. Can they engage? Look for Meganar. That has to be the go sign. And decide against it for the time being.
You can't engage here. You don't have your tables ready on Annie, and Airwax is too low to go in. So H2K is staying around, meaning also Ryu can now go to this mid lane, push it in, deny a bit more CS. So very, very smart decision from H2K by staying here and keeping the pressure.
Well, we'll see what Ryu can do in that mid lane. The rest of H2K gonna get some tower damage down. Siege Minion is up against it. Kiana's gonna bash him with Youngbuck's Mega Gnar transformation in the defensive position. H2K grabbed their third uncontested tower of the game. They don't seem to be backing off just yet, but let's see how they decide to play this out. 1 minute till Dragon.
Just a smart play, also again staying around, knowing Copenhagen Wolves couldn't actually jump onto him. Ryu again pushing in the mid lane, constantly keeping the waves at Copenhagen Wolves tower, so they are forced to just sit back and farm, and making H2K able to actually walk around the map like they want to.
So, Copenhagen Wolves definitely not starting the game the way they wanted to. We talked about how strong their champs were in the laning phase in picks and bans. And simply put, they've just been bullied around the map. Yes, Friezen Unlimited held a CS lead against Kiannon and Voidal, but it's only 10 CS for the time being. And with the tower gold, Kiannon's in a good position thus far. So H2K must be feeling confident about their mid to late game prospects, considering they've got three. Arguably the most difficult part of the game for them.
Yeah, I want to see if Freeze actually will go for BT as his second item. I've seen it before from him where he goes full attack damage, doesn't even rely on attack speed other than just from his boots. It's all about just hitting as hard as possible whenever he can. Oh, onto Lulex!
Oh, Airwax has decided to go in. Cataclysm is up. The Whirling Death flew out. The Whirling Death flies back. Monsoon channeled very early from Voidal. Will that be impactful? The first kill of the fight will be Soren. He's down. Oduwamne is running amok in the team. And Youngbuck, he gets cancelled from his hop. He doesn't get away. We do see the slow coming down from Ryu as H2K are trying to run down the targets. That was a chilling smite onto Youngbuck. He's slowed. Collateral damage pops like a water balloon from the background. Unlimited is the next target. And it's Oduwamne that picks it up. Sion is 4-0-2. Three Wolves are down, and H2K are going Dragon.
This was Copenhagen Wolves starting the fight here, but H2K, they were ready, even though Yarnum was running from the bottom lane. Oduwamne just stays in there, and he tanks everything. Like, how are you going to kill this Sion? Ever?
Not. I mean, he's 4-0-2 Spirit Visage, plus he's got the Frozen Heart completed. Dragon secured for H2K. That makes it a 4,000 gold lead. Ryu, again, with a very, very good push the moment. There's objectives elsewhere. He's in the bottom lane. Here's the replay.
Let's see it again. Yana's in the bottom lane. So Copenhagen Wolves, they start the fight here. But Lulex, nice enough, just disengage from it. And now Oduwamne goes in. Every single member from Copenhagen will just have to try and hit him. And you're not going to kill him. So the rest of H2K can keep chasing him. But you have a caster in. You want these long team fights where he can jump in and out again and again. Keep chasing. And then in the very end, H2K, once Yana actually joins in, can jump a few more kills.
4 versus 5, and H2K come out ahead until Yarnen joins at the end. And you've got to add to the fact that Mega Gnar was once again not available. Copenhagen Wolves are initiating not when everybody is on the same page. That was a dive onto Lulex's Elise, and he just repelled once all the committed engage was gone.
And also the full tank Elise here from Lulex. Went for Juggernaut as his jungle in China, now obviously just continuing to build full tank shoots. He's gonna be in the front line. Oduwamba is gonna be in the front line. Freeze as Draven. You can't really just ignore them and run past them. You have to stand there and hit these tanks. So them building all these tanks that's getting their attack speed reduction as well, it's gonna make it so hard for Freeze to actually do anything in these team fights. And then it's all about Zoran all of a sudden, and he needs more time to scale up on his Kashu here. He needs his tier 40 stacks, needs more stacks from his poison as well before he can really start doing anything in these fights here. So H2K should just keep trying to force team fights.
Well, it looks like they have the options available to them. Draven, not the champion you typically associate with being the greatest of tank killers, and he's gonna have an incredible mega tank in Oduwamba to get through before even considering at least 2,500 HP already. Starting to stack up those resistances. H2K pushing the waves out. So Oduwamba is up in the top lane. The rest of H2K are moving up there shortly, but Copenhagen Wolves do look like they're in place to defend. So wisely, H2K split to another lane.
It's fun to see H2K. They don't really split push and pressure by denying a lot of vision from the enemy team and placing a lot of ward themselves in the enemy jungle. It's more of them just looking at the minion waves and knowing when to move from lane to lane. That's why they constantly go into the top lane, push it in, then they can go back to mid lane where Yharnam is sitting at the moment, building up the wave down this bottom lane as well. It is slow pushing for them, so every single lane pushing in here and making it very easy for them to just move through. Don't even have to invest a lot of money on wards.
Well, let's see if the vision gain comes back to bite them a little bit. Copenhagen Wolves have got a lot of engage on their side, so if H2K are out of position, that could be one way for the Wolves to start clawing that deficit back. Truthfully, 5k gold, and seeing how tanky that front line is, Copenhagen Wolves really, really have to punish a misplay.
Yeah, so they're going to need Unlimited to have his flash ready as often as possible and be able to start the fight on Annie. So I would like to see Distortion being built very soon for him and charming his Moby boots. And potentially even going for a Talisman if he wants to. You're very squishy, but it's been the style in Korea for the Annie support, just you have even more mobility to always start these fights together with Airwax, of course, jumping in. Because Meganar hasn't been available for Young Buck, and he's actually done nothing in these team fights.
No, he really hasn't. Young Buck's been a non-factor, and Unlimited Annie engages have been also not opportune. You know, Voidal in the bottom lane earlier, jumping onto Lulex in the river. It hasn't actually paid dividends yet for the Copenhagen Wolves. So let's see how H2K sets up. They're trying to get some wards down, but I think decent enough defensive vision from the Copenhagen Wolves. H2K are just bullying with the strength they have at the moment.
And what Jumbo is trying to do at the moment, because he's so far behind, he just went for flat HP, getting that Warmox here. Typically, if you need to itemize against physical damage and magic damage, if you don't have any gold, you just have to go for flat HP, and that's what he's been doing here. But it's just making him extremely weak. He doesn't offer any special utility outside of his kit on Gnar here.
So, Soren defending the middle lane, the rest of H2K pushing the bottom lane. Hyonan was late to the party. We do see Soren has hit a bit of an item spike. He's got the Archangels completed, upgraded to Seraphs, as well as that Rylai's Crystal Scepter.
Once again, H2K, looking at this, at the lanes here, how they're pushing, they're pinging the top side, saying, okay, that one, once it gets into the tower, it's gonna bounce back and start pushing it in our favor. So let's just stay around, even sending up Ryo now just to get a bit of the farm as well. So constantly putting focus on every single lane pushing down, so the Copenhagen Wolves just have to run from tower to tower to defend.
Let's see how they do. I mean, that gold beat continues to grow. H2K are continuing to dance around the map. However, the vision is falling off. A few minutes ago, Martin, you were highlighting how H2K don't necessarily have the greatest ward game. And you can see it exemplified on the minimap. There's a whole lot missing. 55 seconds before the next dragon spawns. Each team has one thus far. And it feels like Copenhagen Wolves do not want to give this one up. They just have to be so, so careful. In a straight-up fight against H2K, I'm not convinced that they can lock anybody down or kill anybody, because that is a tanky Sion, that is a tanky Elise, and
they won't be able to fight.
Yeah.
They're gonna need a last Whisper on Freeze, they're gonna need a Void Staff on Soren before they can actually even think about fighting here, because they cannot burn through Elise and Sion in this situation. And even if they do, Janna is there for the disengage, keeping Yharnam and Ryu safe. So this next dragon fight here is going to be extremely hard to go
back. Copenhagen Wolves.
Look at the items being completed as well. Phantom Dancer now for Yharnam. You had the Hourglass for Ryu as well, making it harder to kill him. And Sunfight game completed for Oduwamba. would have loved a Randu and Zoman, but I'll take Sunfire for now because he wants to keep pushing his lead.
Yeah, why not? You've got the advantage, you've got the moment. Also, massive props to our Observer team for highlighting those Dragon and Baron spawns. Super, super cool animations. H2K on the Dragon. Nobody from Copenhagen Wolves around. They tried to move out a minute ago, but it was too early. May not have had the exact time. And H2K secure the second tower, second Dragon of the game.
Honestly, at this point here for H2K, they don't really feel like they want to just keep pushing down the lanes. Start setting up a Baron. You have a Sion who can tank it forever with all the armor he's built up, and you can just force Copenhagen Wolves to move out of the base, get up towards you, and take a bad team fight.
Well, let's see what H2K decide to do. Their team comp is not necessarily the greatest when it comes to Siege, and you don't want to put yourself in a position... I'm trying to be polite here. You don't want to put yourself in a position where Copenhagen Wolves could get the engage, could get those multi-man stuns from Gnar, from Annie, and from Soren's Cassio as well. A lot of defensive wards there from the Wolves. They smell a Baron. They smell that H2K could be making that fall.
And that's also why Odo Amnes in the bot lane here with his teleport in case someone goes down to gank him, then four members start the Baron here. Or if anything else happens, someone dies on the map, Odo Amnes can instantly teleport to the Baron himself and tank it. So that's why they keep him on the bottom side, and Ryo without the teleport was on the top side of the map, split pushing. But once again though, just moving down with the minion waves, you don't need to place wards in the enemy jungle, just time it, you're constantly pushing them up, easy tower once again.
And I really like the way that Hyonin is using that smoke screen from Graves, just denying vision from the Wolves while they're trying to defend. It's not a massive, massive play, but again, any small advantage, tower secured. H2K move to the middle lane, get a couple of auto attacks down before the Wolves respond. And H2K trying to find a window of opportunity.
And let's just remember, this is a team H2K who lost their star mid laner, who we saw earlier today against Elements, have a fantastic game on Xerath. He's gone. They're picking up Ryo, a guy who's not been impressive here in Europe, obviously has a lot of history in Korea. He used to be one of the best mid laners back in Season 3 for them, basically gone downhill since. And he's had actually a decent showing in here. I mean, if you go from being playing against SK Telecom in the OGN Finals to playing for HSK in the LCS, it has gone downhill, I have to say.
Fair enough. I struggle to argue with you there. Odo Amne, unstoppable onslaught, he's running, who can he find?
Youngbug.
He gets Youngbug! That's a goal, but then nothing else happens! And Odo Amne...
His team couldn't follow, he was just rushing forward there.
The thing that was the best about that, while he was running, everybody in the audience was stamping their feet. That was phenomenal, you guys rock, unfortunately.
That's why everyone loves Sion. He has the coolest ulti in the game.
Coolest ulti in the game, that's a bit of a sell. But it worked out. H2K gonna continue trying to siege up this inner turret, and listen to those stamps. These guys want something to happen. H2K on the tower. There's the engage. Timbers comes down. Copenhagen Wolves stun up H2K. The first victim of the fight will be Lulex, but can they get more? Odo Amne is split from the rest of the team, and the Wolves, they get one down.
Ryu's
it's too
done.
Little. It's too late. Ryu gonna rip walk over the wall, and the Wolves, they defend, they hold fast, they get a kill.
The very first time H2K decided to actually group up and try and siege down a tower while all five members from Copenhagen Wolves are waiting around. They get the engage, flash tables from Unlimited. He's always the guy starting the fights. Pick up a kill, but basically just delay H2K now from actually walking back down towards his mid lane.
They need to do a whole lot more of those if they want to bring themselves back into this game. 29 minutes on the clock. It's around 6,000 gold difference. Freeze is sitting on a decent chunk of change, just over 1,000 gold. Gonna back off himself to start picking up some items, but there's some big, big disparities. The top lane in particular, nearly 3,000 gold that Odo Amne has as the advantage.
I'm not sure why Soren at the moment here is not trying to build some magic penetration. You have no boots upgraded, and you have no void stuff instead. Going for, oh well, upgrades the boots now, thank you. But at least seems like he wants to go for either the death cap, which would be a little bit overkill on Casio here. So it could be the Hourglass instead, but you need to get a Void Staff. I mean, it's all about killing the frontline from H2K at the moment if you want to win team fights, build towards it.
Well, let's see what he decides to do. H2K have hit a... They've hit a Sion wall because they don't really have a game plan for breaking this inner line of turrets.
Baron.
You mentioned Baron 10 minutes ago. It's taken them a while to think about it, but they haven't started it yet. Copenhagen Wolves, look at the cooldowns. There is no tippers available. There is no flash available for Unlimited. Wolves need to buy some more time before they have that same level of engage.
That's why H2K setting up the Baron for now, just putting all the pink wards here, and one misplay from Copenhagen Wolves, one person showing in the bottom lane who's not young but with teleport, and H2K can just start it. But they should just stay around. Wait for Copenhagen Wolves to face check you, and then you get a perfect fight. Not around the tower, and Unlimited has no flash. He can't be the guy to start it because he can't even see you in there. So just stay around this Baron and force Copenhagen Wolves to react.
Hey, H2K are finally doing that. They've started the Baron. Or Tibbers is available for Unlimited. Whirling Death goes out. Whirling Death comes back. Copenhagen Wolves, let's see what they can do. Odawabne is tanking Baron from the background. Minions have taken a tower for the Copenhagen Wolves. They've done what the champions could not. And H2K give up their first tower. They back away from Baron. Wolves, they didn't commit to the fight, but they dissuaded the Baron. 30 seconds till Dragon. You have to think H2K will go Dragon and then start off the infamous European Baron dance.
Let's see how it works this season here, if it's going to be the same. Copenhagen Wolves, though, they want Lulix.
Let's find out.
No flash.
Chilling Smite goes out. Lulix does still have Repel available. Poison was ticking, but he managed to
survive. Although Amnes in the river here, he has pink wards around him. He can start his ulti if he wants to.
Well, let's see what they decide to do. Remember, there will be no Lulix if a dragon fight were to ensue. Copenhagen Wolves are going to have position. The rest of H2K,
they've got Baron.
They've split away. Odawamne plus Kianan is there as well. Whirling Death is not up for long range damage. Copenhagen Wolves have got that ward down. Baron's going relatively slowly. Not the fastest, but H2K have been smart. They've delayed the dragon from the Wolves.
Exactly, that was a very, very smart play. Lulix was caught out of position just when the dragon spawned, so the Wolves could actually have gone down five people and just taken it. But because H2K starts this Baron here and disengage as well, don't want to risk it. By time, Lulix is back here. Did lose a mid tower for it, however, so you get a little bit punished for Lulix actually being caught out.
Let's keep our eyes on Odawamne there. Last time, everybody was in the mid lane. He came running.
Oh, Ryu!
What are you doing? Manages just to get away, got some armor, manages just to survive the auto attack. All right, we go down bottom, Unlimited. That looked like a flash Tibbers, but Hyannon gets away, still has flash and heal available. Airwax and Youngbuck both stunned up under the tower, and all of a sudden, it's the Copenhagen Wolves that are sieging. That 5,000 gold difference is shrinking to 4,000, and it's slightly less impactful as the game goes on.
It's fun to see, though, because none of the teams have a very good, like, siege comp. It's all about, like, fighting around these towers here, fighting in the jungle, now onto the dragon. Yannin isn't there, so again, Copenhagen Wolves getting back in the game here.
Oh, let's look at Odawamne. He's running in. He gets
it's
a double. That's a double stun. Youngbuck is about to become Mega Gnar, but he's exhausted. That is a massive stun. He locks H2K up against the wall. Soren gets a first kill of the fight, but Ryu starts tearing them apart. That's a double kill for his Kassadin. Copenhagen Wolves, they did get the dragon. However, they lose two team members immediately after.
It really shows how confident H2K are here. Four people, they engage. Yannin was running from base, he wasn't even close to the fight, and still managed to win it. Copenhagen Wolves got the dragon, though delayed. H2K getting towards this third dragon, given the movement speed. Instead, though, wants to get a tower. These teams really trade a lot.
Well, they definitely don't have the ability to take towers too much, but here's that team fight again.
So again, Odawamne, he's so tanky. He goes in 1v5, he can tank everything. Youngbuck, first time he actually gets Mega Gnar in a fight. Four people smacked into the wall here. Beautiful setup, but it's just not enough. It takes such a long time for you to kill the tanks. Ryu on this Kassadin managed to clean up some kills.
Well, you have to say it again. That's the second, third team fight this game that Hyannon's just not been around for. He's constantly pushing those waves or elsewhere as the fight starts. H2K are so far ahead that it's not really made a big difference. But Hyannon needs to try to rejoin his team if he wants to make his later game team fights more impactful. So H2K go back to that pushing. These are some of the more exciting team fights we've seen today, because truthfully both of these team comps are built around 5v5s.
Yeah, and right here also we see the base gates. We haven't actually seen anyone use them yet, but that's one of the reasons for H2K not just walking down the base. So many flank options from Copenhagen Wolves with a Jarvan, with Annie and Gnar, of course, to engage on you through the gates here. Instead, another team fight.
Here comes Odawamne there. He finds Zorin. In the background, we do see a Cataclysm from Airwax, and both of these teams are split. Odawamne is tanking up four members of the Copenhagen Wolves as Lulix re-engages. That's a double stun from Zorin. First victim of the fight is Lulix, followed
They're
very quickly
it.
By Odawamne. But here comes the melee Odawamne and his Sion passive. Copenhagen Wolves have won this team fight. They've got two kills without reply, and they have dug deep. They have defended, and they have set their sights on Baron.
And one once again, HTK, they want to start the fight here. Odorama actually got a fairly good ulti off here, hitting the back line, but then there's no follow-up, and Freeze has his last whisper completed, so he can start burning through the sign, straight down to Baron. Teleport for Jungbok from the base as soon as he can.
Well, let's see what they can do. Baron is going low, HTK have backed away. They decide not to engage, and all of a sudden, 35 minutes on the clock, Freeze 1-0-3. Copenhagen Wolves, they've defended. H2K gave Copenhagen Wolves more time than they should have, and that has allowed the Wolves to get back into this game.
Yeah, Soren really been able to stack his passive as well here on Kashio, so he's getting very, very strong. Once again, though, he really doesn't want any magic penetration from a Void Staff. Going towards the Death Cab now.
So let's take a look at his AP. 765 ability power. If I'm reading that tooltip correctly, he has maxed out those poison stacks as well. So that is a very, very hard-hitting Cassio. If given enough time, he's going to melt through HTK, despite the fact that they've got all of these tank stacks. With Baron buff on, let's see if Copenhagen Wolves can get some more towers. They're going to set their sights to the top outer towers.
Way back in champ select, we were looking at H2K's comp and saying they only have two damage dealers, Kassadin and a Graves. In the mid game, because Odoamne was so far ahead, he could tank up everything, buy enough time for Yharnam and Ryu to do enough damage to clean up the fights and win them for H2K. But now, because Freeze is starting to deal again with the last whisper, Zorn is stacking up as well from his poison. There's so much damage suddenly on the Copenhagen Wolves side that H2K can't really survive long enough anymore with their front line. But we're gonna have to see what happens in the next teamfight, because we know it's gonna happen. I mean, as soon as this Baron buff is gone and Copenhagen Wolves move up to a tower, H2K is gonna try to engage.
And the same vice versa, neither of these teams.
It's not been a pretty game, but it's been pretty fun to watch.
The team fights have been worth it, that is for sure. Gold is now even for the first time in a very, very long time. Odoamne is going to look for those opportunities to stamp his feet all the way down the lane. And the Copenhagen Wolves, they've done a decent enough job to defend, to bring themselves back in this. The question is, how do they break the inhibitor line of turrets? That's the biggest question, because a tower dive, truthfully, from either team could just turn so horribly, horribly wrong.
Yeah, we might see the situation where both teams are just waiting for dragons to spawn, and then you take it and you start moving towards this fifth dragon where you get the massive buff, and then you start looking for the tower dive. That's when you start looking to open up the base here with, of course, the base gates, because again, both teams have the option to flank through the gates here. Potential from Odoamne, of course, on H2K's side.
Now, we do see Soren is doing much better this game than maybe traditionally we've expected from Copenhagen Wolves mid laner, 5-3-1. But I want to go back and echo what Shox and Krepo were saying on the analyst desk about how important the Copenhagen Wolves jungler is to their team. Airwax has been involved in every single kill that his team has put on the board, 1-0-6. And he continues to be a very impactful member with those cataclysms once these team fights break
every single kill?
Yeah, 1-0-6.
Oh, sorry, I forgot to talk about Soren.
No. Airwax.
5+1, that's yeah. 6.
Well, I'm not that bad at math. You have made
a lot of mistakes.
Anyways, Copenhagen Wolves, they've got themselves in a turret in the bottom lane, and they've stolen away the blue buff, and they've got position on Dragon. It's now the Wolves that are in control.
And Freeze at the moment, he's sitting on 580 stacks. Give that man a kill, and he's rich forever. He has the last whisper. Yharnam does not have the last whisper yet here. So it will be hard for him to actually break through Jungbok. And once again, H2K realizing we can't actually fight at the moment. We need to get the pick here. We need to get the right engage. Otherwise, we just have to stay back and we can't risk going 5 versus 5.
So Dragon number 3 secured for the Copenhagen Wolves. Baron buff has expired. The one tower down, but they are now 100 gold in the lead. The super tanks of the top lane continue to itemize in the beefy front. You've got that thorn mail.
Yes, but now you're just a tank, and now comes the problem where you can't kill anyone, which is what signed us. I mean, he builds full tank. He had a fantastic early to mid game from Odoamna's side, but now it's up to Ryu and Yharnam to step up. And that might not work. I mean, Yharnam has to get that last whisper before the next team fight.
Now we'll see if he can. Currently sitting on 1,600 gold, so not too far off, but I don't know if he's going to get the time that he needs or wants. Airwax spots out members of HTK with a very smart ward. And the rest of the Wolves, they've grouped themselves up. So let's see how they siege. Deep vision. Flash Antibus is available for Unlimited. Just cocoon to at least minimize that. Ryu. Rift walks from the knock-up. Wolves, they want an engage. They are looking for a limb to bite onto, and H2K is not providing one.
No, and right now they have to worry about the side lanes pushing, so backing away from Komingos, you gotta start the slow push in your side lanes if you want a group 5 at this point here. Otherwise, these minions can do a lot of damage to your base. And one tower going down, opening up inhibitor, suddenly H2K has an opening to get back in the game. So you need to time it, you gotta start the slow push, and then you can go 5 mid and keep H2K there and wait for your minions to push up, and then you can rotate between the lanes and take down towers.
Well, we'll see if they decide to do that. Ryu's gonna get caught out, stun's gonna come down, Zhonya's Hourglass comes up. I think the stun was actually wasted there, and Flash plus Riftwalk, Whirling Death goes out, that's the Chilling Smite. Ryu's locked in place,
nope,
he's gonna get caught out, Ignite takes him down. There's a fair amount of investment from the side of Copenhagen Wolves, but they get the kill, and they alleviate any of the pressure H2K built up.
Not really sure what Ryu was trying to do though. All alone, walking in the jungle, no wards. His team was sitting in mid lane. That actually just ends up giving a kill. Sadly for Copenhagen Wolves, Freeze didn't manage to get it with his now 600 stacks.
Well, we'll see how much, we'll see how much gold he manages to cash in when he eventually gets that. But you have to say Ryu's decision making, a little more reminiscent of what we had seen from him when he was playing for Millennium. Maybe a little bit when he was playing for Rocket.
It's kind of solo queue. That's
the point. He hasn't really settled down in a team. This is a guy who's played in three now LCS squads, with, well, ex-LCS at least, with Millennium, Rocket, and now H2K. So he needs to try find his footing. And he needs to try blow people up, because for the time being, he's one of only two damage sources for H2K.
And we actually see a lot of the members here picking up the Warp Totem instead of sweeping lanes late game, of course, with the buffs here. In 5.1, the Greater Vision Totem, you can now place a ward every single minute, a green ward that is, in this situation. Which actually gives you a lot of wards when you have full item build. You also have a Sidestone on Lulex here, but also means it's a lot harder now to clear them, because there's so many more wards in place and less sweeping lenses.
So we'll see if they can make use of that vision, because they simply have not really made great use of it this game. We did see Lulex running around with that Elixir of Iron. His giant size up. Here comes the onslaught. That's a decent stun. They've caught Unlimited. He's the first victim, but what more can they do? Petrifying Gaze locks up members of H2K. Asorin is on the retreat. The only victim thus far has been Annie, and the slow connects from Odo 1 minute. But Yannick, Airworks, they re-engage. Where is Yannick? What can he do? Ryu's in the back line, but he's been forced away. They've killed Odo 1 minute. The damage from Copenhagen Wolves is enough. And the passive from Sion.
And there's not enough damage from H2K. They have no damage here. Yes, you kill the support. Then what? You can't do anything. Zhonya completely untouched in the backline here. Freeze as well, just dealing all the damage straight to Baron. And just to correct myself from before here, the Greater Stealth Totem, of course, is the one that adds the green ward and has 1 minute cooldown here.
Well, I think
in this case, the Vision Totem is the 2 minute cooldown where you place the pink ward.
Well, Baron number 2 attempted by the Wolves. Do not manage to secure it. And with the kills in the previous fight, again, not going to Freeze. His stacks continue to build. H2K have completely and utterly stalled. Surely they are having some visions of the expansion tournament where they were 0-3'd by the Copenhagen Wolves. Youngbuck has got Meganar, who throws the house, the boulder. Manages to connect, but no further follow-up, and H2K back away.
Sorin is currently sitting on 1,000 EP.
Oh, is that all?
Yeah, I mean, it's nothing.
Not that much.
Oh, I've seen Lulu have the same. So,
he could do better.
Step it up. Don't buy any defensive items here, Soren. Come on, more damage.
Well, we'll see what he decides to eventually finish with. Soren, for the time being, part of the reason that the Copenhagen Wolves are keeping themselves in it. And still, Airwax maintains his 100% kill participation. Lulex is low. Smite is available. Baron is an objective. Here comes Odo Wamne. The unstoppable onslaught plus the Elixir of Iron ticking away. Gonna give his teammates a chance to run up from behind. He's got a whole mess of HP. Cataclysm goes down. Airwax wants Ryu. And they still continue to look for fights. But really, it's just tentative at the moment. Nothing coming from it to Fischio.
No, and Ryu has been sitting on the same items for the last 10, 15 minutes at least. Got no kills, no farm really on this Kassadin. And obviously, no, again, no void star for him. He doesn't really have enough damage to do anything in these fights here. H2K really have to hope Copenhagen was overextends and they get a kill or two on either Freeze or Soren just when the fight starts. It's not enough killing Youngbugs, not enough killing Unlimited. You have to get to one of these two carries.
Well, take a look at that gold difference over time. Copenhagen Wolves really, really felt the pinch up until the 30-odd minutes mark before they pulled it back. That's Dragon number 4. They're one away from that very powerful buff. And for anybody who's a fantasy enthusiast, Copenhagen Wolves team members gave a whole lot of points last split as sleeper agents because they so often had very long games.
Very long games.
CS numbers went up and towers went up all the time.
Dragons, everything.
Game one of the spring split, the Copenhagen Wolves live up to their ethos of 2014 and they drag this to the super late game. The question is, how do they break inhibitor turrets? Because again, they have now stalled. We're H2K stalled.
You wait 6 minutes for the next dragon to spawn. You pick it up. You have five dragons. Then you take a Baron buff. Then you are completely overpowered. And you just walk down the enemy base and smack them in the head. And Soren picked up a Void Staff. Decided to sell his magic resist. Thank
that's
you, Soren.
Simple. That's simple. Deficio says it. He's laid it out. Let's have a look. 1,141 ability power for Cassio. Over 710 stacks on Freeze's passive. The League of Draven wants the gold, and we'll see if he can cash it in. Baron's been started. H2K will not let this one go uncontested.
This thing around, he can't really engage. I mean, as long as you can see Odoamne come in, it's easy for Soren and Freeze to position themselves so he can never get to them, making it very hard for H2K to actually start a fight here.
Looks like Draven actually picked that blue buff up, and this fire is deceiving me. Massive minion waves. Massive minion waves to deal with in the top and bottom if you're an H2K member.
Oh,
that's a flash, that's a Tibbers. Here's the fight. H2K locked up. Baron is still bashing
Freeze
away the background.
Down.
But with Freeze down, can Copenhagen Wolves finish with Soren alone? Cataclysm comes back. Yana's being focused out. AD carries are dead on both sides, but so is the jungler for H2K. Odoamne is in the background, unlimited, along with Soren. Airwax doing the best that they can. Airwax trying to get out as Odoamne gets taken down. Sion passive is up. Can he try get more kills? It's a 3-4. Four for two in this scenario. But with AD carries going down, a messy, messy fight, and the stalemate continues.
So that was like the perfect fight for H2K. They managed to kill Freeze instantly. It's just not enough. They are so far behind now. Copenhagen Wolves pushing on to this top lane.
Well, we'll see if they can get the tower down. They've got a lot of minions behind them. Voidal's got no ability power to speak of and multiple cannon minions to deal with. So that's going to be the tower. Long, long death timers. Has to be the inhibitor as well. H2K come out two members short in the team fight, and I was incorrect. The stalemate did not continue because Copenhagen Wolves have now got absolute map control with minions in the top lane and a way to get behind towers. That can be their way to win this game.
Right, let's see the fight here. Copenhagen decides to engage. He kills onto Yana, so he stays alive. And now Freeze is actually being caught by Odoamne. Real joins in. They get that early kill they needed. But now, who are they going to kill? I mean, Yarnan ends up dying. There's no real damage left. And the rest of Copenhagen Wolves can just start cleaning it up. Odoamne going down here at the very end. And as part of his revenge, he managed to kill the Tibbers. Get 50 gold.
Well, 50 gold OP at the 50-minute mark in the game.
And your four items.
And four, yeah, well,
50 gold.
Hashtag still counts. So we do see, I really want to see if Freeze can actually cash in on that League of Draven passive because he continues to stack it up. Over, is that 860 now? If I'm looking
no reason to fight though for Copenhagen Wolves. Wait for this next dragon to spawn. It's a ticking time bomb. H2K has to go down and try and stop you or try and trade it for Baron here. Let's see what they do. They actually go straight for Baron at this point. Copenhagen Wolves, the dual lane is down his bottom, down the base.
H2K trying to rush it, but they've actually peeled away. They've not committed fully for the objective. Sion does have his ultimate available. Odoamne decides not to pull the trigger. And they
just
backed
H2K,
away.
H2K knowing we have to try something. I mean, we can't just sit and wait. We know we're not going to get that dragon. So we keep trying to get the Baron.
Ooh.
It's our only way of coming back. Unlimited, left behind a little bit.
This is going to be very, very awkward. There's no flash for
Unlimited. Let's go for the base.
Let's see who's going to get in there. Are they going to try rush it down? Odoamne has got some good distance closing.
Oh, they
jump back in. That is a massive gnar! Copenhagen Wolves lock H2K up. They're going to try clean house. Youngbuck re-engages into the fight. Two members of H2K are down. Then they blow up Voidal on the sidelines. Yana is going to be the fourth victim of the fight, and Ryu's even stunned up by
no
Unlimited.
Kills for Freeze.
There is nothing that H2K can do here. Freeze still looking for his second kill of the game. Will he get it? The answer is no.
Game is over.
Copenhagen Wolves have done it in 50 minutes. They have taken H2K out, and that was a hard-fought victory.
But man, this was H2K's game to lose after that great start. Sion was so far ahead. They won the team fight, and then they stopped playing for some reason. Just kind of ran around one by one, got caught out. Copenhagen Wolves got a few dragons, got a few picks, suddenly they could pick up some towers. Bought more time for Zorn and Freeze to scale into late game, got the last Whisper completed for Freeze. And suddenly, you had such an insane amount of damage on the side of Copenhagen Wolves. And a 5-item or 6-item Sion, that's not going to buy you enough time when you only have Kessa and Graves in this situation late game to deal the damage.
Well, stepping back, Copenhagen Wolves have bested H2K in the past. H2K lost Febervin in the offseason, and they needed to prove to the world that they could take out the LCS squads, and it has not come to pass. I think we need to start a new hashtag. Hashtag feed freeze. He ended 1-1-11.
Yeah.
With a billion stacks on Draven.
Just pointless to stack it on Draven if you can't even get a kill.
We'll never know.
What's he doing?
You know what? If he was really worthy of LCS, he would have got the kill.
I agree.
That's what I'm saying.
I agree.
That's what I'm saying. We'll have to hear from him at some point.
Had I been his support, like in the old days, he got zero kills and we lost the game 20 minutes ago.
And you have to call it out. From both squads, that was a fairly sloppy game.
Oh, very sloppy.
In terms of how they played the map.
So none of the teams could really just group up and start sieging down a tower. And instead, H2K putting a lot of focus on, again, pushing the waves, setting up minions or big enough waves so they could go over and take the tower from him. That was a smart play. And Copenhagen Wolves didn't really do anything in return, just had to try and constantly defend. But then H2K decided, you know what, this is working. Let's stop and let's walk around for a few minutes, being caught out and
die. Get caught in the jungle.
Ryo walking in alone, 1v3. His team is sitting in the mid lane. And just some very sloppy mistakes from H2K, and they get punished on this level here, and the Copenhagen Wolves take the game.
It took a long, long time to see Young Bucks not in action, but once it began happening in combination with the Cataclysm, we saw some great Gnars locking up 2, 3, 4 members of H2K, and the moment that CC went down, there was just all the time in the world for Freeze, for Soren to put the damage down. Those team fights were sloppy. It was 12 kills to 18 kills at the end. But they were exciting to watch.
They were, and like every fight, Eriks would go in and lock down Yarn so he couldn't do any damage to his carries, and then Youngberg would be peeling on the Gnar here. So it worked out in the very end, but we have to say, against a team like Fnatic, which we saw earlier here, if they had gotten that lead early on, even Giants from what we saw against MYM, wouldn't have let Copenhagen Wolves back in the game like this.
I definitely, for both of these squads, they need to step away. Look at their vision game. Look at how limited and minimal their ward placements were. And H2K had sort of a good idea with the minion waves, but they just didn't press it hard enough. They just didn't get the, they didn't keep the advantage rolling.
No, and that's what happened. Yeah. And if you don't have the wards placed down to see when Copenhagen was trying all or nothing play to kind of catch you out and get back in the game, you get punished for it. And it's what happened here. It looked fine for them in the start. We saw a lot of focus on Odo Amne. Krepo talked about him being the carry now together with Lulex on the team as Febrian is gone. And it was clearly the tactic, get him going early on this Sion. Problem was rest of the team just couldn't follow in time, became some sloppy plays. Copenhagen Wolves outscaled them.
Yeah, we're starting to get a feel for where the teams lie in terms of the big picture. 10 squads in the LCS stage now. We've got 2 more games today before we start figuring out who you think might be in the top half of the bracket, who you think might be in the bottom half of the groups. Tweet at us, at LOL Esports. Tell us who you think it's going to end up being.
I think Copenhagen Wolves are the greatest team in the world.
You would. You know.
That's also why they're right up here.
You actually did that?
Yeah. I practice this quite a lot. there it is.
Well, we'll have to see if they can keep that up, because truthfully, that sort of early game is going to get punished. Giants demonstrated an ability to do it. Fnatic definitely demonstrated an ability to punish the early game. So, you know, they can't afford to take that long, that slow. 50 minutes, the two previous games were around the 30 to 33 minute mark. This is going to bump the average game time here.
It's still day one. It's still day one.
It is.
Yes, okay. We've had some games where there was a lot of snowballing. Now we had a very long game where Copenhagen managed to come back. It's hard to see too much from it so far. It's only day one. A lot of things can happen. I think tomorrow we have a lot better picture.
Yeah, and one of the things that I do like is the fact that Dragon is becoming a little less important than Baron on this patch. We'll see if that trend continues. For now, though, we've got the code.